Hey everybody, it's good to be with you. Thank you for joining us here at the beginning of the week for our daily reflection, and I hope that you'll be with us each morning as we do this. Well, David said in his message that love is everything, that love is basically our identity, and that every aspect of our life should be characterized by love. Not easy, but essential that that be true of our life as a follower of Jesus. You see, the sign of a genuine follower of Jesus is not only their actions, but also their ability to love people. Well, I don't know about you, but I've kind of started watching the Olympics. You know, it's a fun season to have the Olympics going on, and they're great athletes. I'm amazed always at the athletic prowess of these individuals and realizing that they've been training for this moment, I mean, their entire life practically. And that they're hoping that their name becomes almost a household word, like it did for Michael Phelps, or for Katie Ledecky, or for Simone Biles, lots of other people as well. Their whole identity is wrapped up in their sport and in their success in that sport and on the Olympic stage. And I've seen a lot of them as I've seen them in their, you know, their competition clothes and such. They have the Olympic image tattooed on their bodies. Those five unmistakable rings that are universally understood to represent the Olympics. It sets them apart. Their Olympic participation, it sets them apart, and that's what they want people to see about them, is they are an Olympian. Well, in the same way, love has to be our tattoo, if you will. It's the identifying mark for us as Christians. Love has to be what people see when they consider us, because love is universally recognized. People, when they watch us, when they hear us, they need to think about love. And so John chapter 13, verse 34 and 35 says this, "A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so must you love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another." And then in 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 and 8, it says this, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love." And easily in those two passages, you come to the conclusion that love is everything. Look in the mirror. I want you to look in the mirror today, and I want you to ask the same question that King David asked of God. He said this, "Search me, O God, know my heart, test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me. See if there is any unloving way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting." And so I just want to leave you with that question. What is the identifying mark that people see when they watch you? Is it love? Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for the day and the opportunity to love people. Your mercies are new to us every morning, and so the opportunity to love people is new every day. I pray that love would be the identifying mark that sets us apart, that people see as they watch us, or as they hear us, or as they interact with us. Help us, give us the divine grace today to love well. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you guys. I hope you have a great week.